In my opinion, the ATR 72 is a very dangerous airplane. I believe two factors in its design cause this to be so. First, wing loading. The airplane has insufficient wing area for the loads it is routinely asked to carry. Second, the cord of the wing is too small, which, coupled with high wing loading, makes the aircraft less stable than most other aircraft. Again, these are just my opinions.
Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magnar Nordahl, I am an ATR captain and instructor. And I am recording from Wailoa open window studio. The sky is blue, the birds are singing, and the neighbor is cutting the grass. The comment you just heard in the beginning of this video was about the ATR accident in Brazil earlier this year. And other commenters have also discussed the wing size and stability of ATR 72. What I really appreciate about this commenter is that he clearly states that this is his own opinion, because very often you can read very bombastic statements and claims that have no base in reality at all. So let's talk about it. Does the ATR have too small wings, and is the aircraft unstable? And the best way to approach this is to compare the ATR with the nearest competitor, and that is the Dash 8. In the 50-seat category, we have the ATR 42. And it has a wing area of 54.5 square meters and a maximum takeoff weight of 18,600 kilos. When we divide the max takeoff weight with the wing area, we got 341 kilos per square meter. Meanwhile, the Dash 8 300, which also accommodates around 50 passengers, has a wing area of 56.2 square meters and a max takeoff weight of 19,505 kilos. And this results in a wing loading of 347 kilos per square meter. So they are very close to each other. In fact, the Dash 8 has a slightly higher wing loading. In the 70 to 80 seat category, we have the ATR 72. And it has a wing area of 61 square meters and a maximum takeoff weight of 23,000 kilos. And this represents a wing loading of 377 kilos per square meter. In comparison, we have the Q400. It has a wing area of 64 square meters and a max takeoff weight of 30,481 kilos. And this gives a very high wing loading, in fact 476 kilos per square meter. And this difference is because the Q400 is made for a different kind of operation compared to the ATR 72. The Q400 competes with the jets. And if you want a fast aircraft, you need to reduce the wing area. It's that simple. The wing loading of the Q400 is very similar to that of the CRJ 700, which has 482 kilos per square meter. And if you look at Embraer, the E175, which is the nearest when you compare to seating, it has a wing loading of 555 kilos per square meter. And when you look at the bigger jets from Boeing 77 and up, they will have a wing loading between 600 and 700 kilos per square meter. Because the intention of those aircraft is to fly fast, as efficient as possible. So the conclusion is the ATR 72 does not have a high wing loading compared to other aircraft. And that's because of the role this aircraft is designed to operate in. And that is to fly from relatively short runways and have a modest cruise speed. You cannot get both, right? So, are there any advantages with a long slender wing, which we call a wing with a high aspect ratio? Oh yes. Most of all, it's very efficient. A wing with high aspect ratio generates less induced drag for the same wing area compared to wings with a low aspect ratio. This results in a better lift-to-drag ratio, meaning less power is required, especially at low speeds, for example after an engine failure at takeoff. Gliders are designed for maximum efficiency, and they have very high aspect ratio wings. Boeing and NASA are also exploring high aspect ratio designs with the Sugar Vault project. They aim to reduce emissions by 70% compared to current airliners. The project's demonstrator, the X-66A, is expected to fly in 2028. And if you go back in time to the 1950s, we have the Ourel Dubois HD 31, 32 and 34. About a dozen of those aircraft were built. Even Air France was interested in the design, but in the end they made no orders. The second benefit is the enhanced lift capability. A wing with a high aspect ratio will have more space for flaps, which will both increase the wing area and the lift, and therefore reducing the speed for takeoff and landing. About 70% of the trailing edge of an ATR 72 is dedicated to the flaps. Of course, there are some downsides to a high aspect ratio wing, especially the structural strength, because a long slender wing needs more enforcement. You will have structural support, struts, which of course will increase the drag a bit. You will also need more space on the ground when you taxi and the aircraft is parked. And there might be less space for fuel inside the wings because the cord is quite short. But does the short cord make the aircraft less stable? No, it doesn't. Let me give you one example. It's argued that the consolidated B-24 Liberator was unstable due to its high aspect ratio wing. This wing design generated substantial lift even at low angles of attack and produced very little drag, especially at low speeds. However, at high speeds, the drag increased with this wing. But still, it contributed to high cruise speed, long range, and it could carry a lot of ordnance. The Liberator had a reputation for being difficult to fly. They said it was unstable, but less in the pitch. The main problem was directional stability. In 1942, it was discovered that replacing the twin vertical stabilizers with a single tail fin would improve stability. However, since the aircraft was already in full production, maintaining a high production rate was prioritized over retooling factories to implement this change. Later, Consolidated built the PB4Y-2 Privateer, and this aircraft adopted the single tail fin design. In contrast, the ATR 72 is stable as long as you keep your center of gravity within the certified limits. Imagine the aircraft as a seesaw. The lift forces act through a single point, as does the aircraft's weight, that's the center of gravity. In a conventional aircraft, the center of gravity is ahead of the center of lift. The horizontal stabilizer produces negative lift to balance these forces. If the center of gravity is too far forward, the aircraft becomes overly stable, reducing elevator authority, since the elevator can only generate a certain amount of force. Conversely, if the center of gravity moves too far aft, the aircraft becomes unstable. Only fighter jets want that. And the distance between the center of gravity and the horizontal stabilizer is also important for stability. And in that case, the ATR 72 is more stable than the 42, right? I believe this addresses the questions regarding ATR and the wing. And if you like the content I am making, please consider supporting my channel by becoming a member. That will be a great help for me. Thank you to all of you already supporting my channel. And this is all for this time. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day and happy learning.